Yeah, very good morning. My name is Bajendra Nair. I am working as assistant professor in the Department of Mechanical Engineering. And this semester, I am handling as a subject is fluid mechanics and hydraulic machines. So, I am working in the St. Martin Engineering College. So, today we are going to deal about the water introduction about the fluid mechanics. So, before going to that our lecture, so we'll learn about the what are the course outcomes and course objectives and what is the basic which will lead in the workshop practical application point. So coming to the next slide of this subject. So in this subject, what is the main agenda of this subject? So what are the things we are going to learn? And second one, so after the end of the semester, so what are the outcomes will come? So as a completion of the subject, so what are the practical point of view? So in this subject, in where the application is valid. So that things are coming under the outcomes of the subject. And lesson plan, I plan to handle session 1. And course assessment, so depends on that subject, I assess the some point of view. So we'll go one by one. So first one, so here, and next slide, so what are the objectives of this subject? So first one, basic introduction to the fluid mechanics. So normally this subject, they split up into the three categories. That is, the first objective of this subject in this one, this gives the basic introduction of the fluid mechanics, dimension parameters, and what are the different kinds of the properties of the fluid. So all those things should be coming under the first point of the objective. And second objective of this subject, it gives the entire depth properties of the various aspects, that is various in the boundary layers. So where the fluid should be close on the particular kind of the surface or kind particular kind of the boundary layer. So how the fluid should be behave, how the fluid should be response particular object. So that thing is coming under the second objective of this one. And third one, we can refer to some basic knowledge, the dimensions, the conversion of the units. So here in this one, we are going to that some kinds of different types of dimensions and everything will go in the parameters. And after that last one, what are the properties? The fluid again having the can be classified into the, there are two categories. That is a microscopic point of view and a macroscopic point of view. So in coming to that microscopic point of view, the fluid, that is gases, the small molecules, that molecules should be jumped from the one place to the another place. So that kind of the particular all the parameters we can discuss in the kind of the properties and microscopic and a macroscopic point. And next one, we discuss the what are the outcomes here in the this particular subject. So first outcome of this one is can differentiate between the three parameters, that is the fluid, liquid and gases. So in this subject, this one is should be categorized into the daily only the two kind of the categories, that is only the liquid and the gases. So solid also we get here, but the particular it should be cannot be deformed into the one direction of the way. So but in case of the fluid or either in case of the gases, they does not have a particular shape and size, but in case of coming to the solid, it has the particular weight and particular shape and size, they have their own way. But in case of this fluid and the gases, they have the compressible and incompressible nature point of view. You can learn from the course outcome from the first point. And second one, it can able to describe the what fluid mechanics is all about. So what are the different all the parameters, the properties of the entire all the properties of the fluid. You can able to learn about from the other fluids. And also be able to name the historical figures that have impact the fluid should be acting on the wind or in the jet. So those things are should also be coming up from this subject. And can recognize the importance, dimension, homogeneity in engineering calculation point of view. And able to handle the conversion of the units without having any error. And also having the, some different basic properties of the fluid. And next another one, we'll go further one by one. So first one, chapter 1. So here it can use the introduction to the fluid. So first, what is the meaning of the fluid and what is the meaning of the mechanics? So fluid is nothing but it is one of the substances, it can flow. That part is one of the small basic fundamental definition of the fluid. Fluid is a substance, it can flow. That means substance means it having that some space, either it can occupy the volume, it has some properties, all the things are coming under the substance. So those are the substance, it can should be the flow. So then it is called as fluid. And the mechanism is nothing but here, it's having the considered as the various kinds of the forces or without forces on the mechanism. And next one, here we go for the all the parameters in the this one. So this one I told you that the fluid mechanics can be categorized into the two ways. That is the one is the fluid mechanics and hydraulic mechanics. So in case of coming to the fluid mechanics here, the mechanics is also called as the mechanics of fluid. So fluid mechanics is a branch of engineering science which deals with the behavior of the fluid under the condition of the either should be the rest condition or either in the motion condition. So then it's called as a fluid mechanics. So I told you the fluid definition, that is it is a substance of can flow of the it having the capable of flow, then it's called as a fluid. So then again the fluid mechanics, the combination of fluid and a mechanics, it's a branch of engineering science. It can deals with the behavior of the fluid, either it should be in the rest condition or either in the motion. And coming to the hydraulic machinery, so it is also called as the word should be coming from the Hooder. So it is also one of the branch of science which deals with the water, or either should be in the rest condition or either in the motion condition. Both are the same. But in case of coming to the hydraulics, here we are having some experimental observation. It should be in the water flow and also some other forces should be acting on the other parameter. Then that is called as the hydraulics. So the hydraulics is nothing but here the water should be either impacting on some other parameter. Either should be on the turbines or jets or any kind of the other object. So that is called as the hydraulic machines. It's coming to the next slide here. So go for one by one. So fluid mechanics. The fluid mechanics is a study of behavior of fluid. Either should be the rest. If the fluid should be in that rest condition, then that is called as a statics. So fluid should be either in the rest condition. So that is the part is called as the fluid statics. If the fluid should be in that motion, that means here we are not considering the other kind of the forces, then that is called as a kinematics. So here, in case of this one, we are considering some other kind of the forces on the fluid, then that part is called as the fluid dynamics. So here, the fluid mechanics can be categorized into the three categories. One is the statics, second is the kinematics, and third one is the dynamics. So statics is nothing but here, the fluid should be in the rest condition. If it is in the kinematics, the fluid should be in that mobile, but in that one, we are not considering the other forces. Then that part is called as the kinematics. If we are considering the forces on the fluid, then that part is called as the dynamics. So coming to the next one, we go for next one in this fluid. So I told you that here the fluid is substance, it can continuously deform. So here the fluid is should be static. That means if the branch of science which deals with that in the rest condition only, that is called as the fluid static. If the fluid is in the motion, then that is called as a fluid dynamic. So in this part, we are considering as the forces on the fluid. So there are the different applications of the fluids or mechanics. So here in this one, coming to that all practical application point of view, if the flow of the fluid in a river or either in the sea or marine, any kind of application. So when they are coming to the aeroplane, how the fluid forces are either gas or either some kind of the forces acting on the outside, that is called as in the computational fluid dynamics. So that one it should be discussed in the aeroplane application point of view also. And also another major important is while producing generating the power, either in the steam power plant or either hydro power plant. So there are some of the most application. Another one is our human body. We are breathing the air, so that is gas. So that one having also the flow of molecules. So that one also another application of that one. So coming to the car, They are having the number of publications in the automobile part, either in the drink or either should be the air impacting on the body. So that all should be coming under the automobile application point of view. And the standard one is coming to the wind turbine. So if they help out the waves, if they help out the fluids, so then the wind is generated. So that the combination of the both fluid and the gases, then you will get the wind velocity. So due to that one also they have in the some of one of the application. And coming to the piping, while producing the crude oil, in case of offshore or onshore, they have the fluid will flow in a particular pipe, then one layer of the fluid to another layer of the fluid, how that the fluid should flow, that is one of the practical application of this one. So these are all are the different applications of this particular subject. And next another thing, so here, so another most important of the fluid mechanics. So here they are the main agenda of the particular element. So same applications of the this one. So these are the history of the fluid mechanics. So the subject should be developed with that the fluid mechanics. It should be the all some parameters should develop with that the olden days. So given this all the dispersion here. So here, what is the difference between? So here we consider only the fluid and the gases only, but solid we are not considering in this part. So why? Because of I have a small difference between the fluid and the solid. So in case of particular solid, it have prepared the shape. Either it should be the cylindrical or it have any kind of the shape which having the solid part. But in case of the fluid, it having the own shape. Take the best example of a glass of water. If you can take it, then water should be doesn't have a particular shape. It should be close on the fluid and the flow. So that's why it does not have any prepared shape in the coming to the either fluid or either the gas. But in case of the item, the solid part, it has a very hard and not easily deformed. Here, in case of coming to the part and solid, we have to apply the force at particular load beyond that. At critical point, it should be goes to the breaking of the solid. But in case of coming to the liquid or even the gases, it should be soft or easily it can deform their particular own direction. And it cannot deform continuously under the shear stress. So here, in case of solid part of, if you apply the load, it should be cannot be moved to tendency to the other part. So here, you have to apply the load on the particular force that is beyond their limit of the solid. Then only it should be deformed, or after that it should be having the breaking. But in case of the fluid, it should be deformed continuously when you are applying the either in the shear state or either in the normal flow. But if you are solid, you have to apply the normal flow, then only tendency to close up, it can move them from one part to the another. And next, okay, so next class we will go to discuss the different properties of the fluid. So you can carry the. You have any doubts? We can.